We're running out of time.
I'm going in.
Oh, hey guys. I'm gonna try this. It doesn't seem to be working. But maybe I am streaming right now and I don't realize it, so I'm just gonna go through the motions right now. And show you some changes that I have done to the world since a lot of you have seen it. So there is a bunch of new stuff that a lot of people haven't seen, because I had a surgery and I've been just playing Minecraft recovering from the surgery. So a lot of stuff has been done, a lot of things that people have not seen, a lot of things I haven't recorded for the camera, and I just barely, yesterday, went into the end. My mobile device is saying that I'm offline right now. But whenever I look at Twitch online, yeah, it's showing me, so I don't know what's going on. So the thing that I normally look at the comments is going, I'm not going to give you comments today. So, I guess I'm not going to have comments today. So, as you see, I did go to the end. I destroyed the dragon. And I got some of this stuff. So, I'm working to hurt my leggings and finish making some purple so I can get some of these blocks. And more importantly, the end rods. The end rods are for a special project that I can't show you right now, but I am going to work on it a little bit. At least the resource gathering part of it. But first we're going to do a little inventory cleaning. Let's get rid of these. I want to make sure that I know where these lights are, because they go on into the new secret project. And I want to get some wood cut, some dark wood, because I need some fences for my beautiful new farms. You know, when you start a new world, you have like many farms that you work with. I guess I'll just go like this. And, why did I just move my axe? The thing that I need most right now. And those farms eventually don't suffice enough for you in the future. And having villagers and means to trade veggies like potatoes and carrots and stuff like that. I need to get a big supply of veggies and carrot and just the normal farm that I normally make, which is, what is it, 9x9, isn't going to cut it for this particular program. So I am moving my farms away from where they are now, which is right next to my main base here at spawn, to outside the spawn chunks, because there's lots of entities involved. You know, hundreds of cows, hundreds of sheep, hundreds of pigs. And I would like to get that stuff out of my spawn chunks. And the growing veggies and stuff. Just so the game works a little bit better. I also noticed that I've been running the game for the last few days with a render distance of 24. And that doesn't make for a game that runs too well. So, I'm just going to be getting a little bit of wood so I can finish making these fences and seeing that the new places for the farms are right next to a dark oak forest or whatever they are called, I like to use the products that are in that area. So I'm making the fences out of dark oak wood. And as you can tell, I'm making a bunch of fences. Still kind of upset that my mobile app, where I can check comments to see if anybody's actually talking to me right now, ain't working. I hate playing Minecraft on small screen. I can't do it at all. So I guess every once in a while I'm going to have to pause and look to see if there's anybody in chat so I can say hi and be a nice guy. So if you haven't heard, or if you don't follow me, normally I am recovering from surgery. I had a gallbladder taken out of me, so I've been playing a shit ton of Minecraft. I made a whole bunch of videos right away, then realized that I'm actually like 5 weeks ahead of myself in the series, and I don't like being that ahead of myself, so I am... I stopped recording, basically, but continued working on the world, and a lot of things have been done to make my world a little easier and so forth that nobody has really seen yet. And I guess I should be keeping this all as a secret, but, you know, it's stuff I'm working on, and I'm going to be working on it in the stream, so you may see something in the stream and go, what the hell did that happen? And you're going to see it in a couple of months and go, oh, that's what he was working on when. So I apologize for that, because there are going to be some massive... I'm getting some weird shit going on in my headphones. I don't know what's going on with the game. I'm hoping this is streaming okay. If not, it's not a big deal, because you know what? I don't stream that often. It's not going to be part of my life right now. And I'm just on here trying to have a little bit of fun, do some work, share this work with you guys a little bit, and get some stuff done. Why did I put all of that wood in here? I just need 2 stacks just in case. So let me show you what I've been working on. One thing that you haven't seen yet, and this is overdoing it, in video. You haven't seen the rainbow in video yet. Yeah, that's my sheep farm. You haven't seen this. Well, I'm getting some massive crackles in my headphones. I'm hoping it's not going out on Twitch. But, I got the 6 beacon, which nobody ever actually needs to use, because 6 beacons is a little much, but I figured, you know, the first beacon in the world, I might as well overdo it. And I also have a beacon in the end, because my secret project for episode number 50, and just to remind you, I'm on episode number 26, so episode 50 should be pretty dynamic, because I've been working on it pretty much... for a very long time, and it's going to be a secret little project that's going to be released with the world download in episode 50 of the Jam series. So if you're interested in that, go to YouTube, KMA's Corner, and it will be there. So let me just see something real quick. Oh, I have one person following, and I bet you it's me. Let's see if I can look in chat. Viewers list, me. So supposedly, yeah, well, I'm watching myself on this old computer. So if anybody says hi, I should make the chats, like, seeable in the game itself, but... my mobile device that I look on chats is pissing me off. Last time I did this, I had no problem seeing what I was doing. Browse. Let's... KMA's Corner is... working right now. It's just not working on your end. Give me a second. Let me go... see if I can get it the other way. And maybe it will show up and I can actually talk to somebody. You guys, I don't have two monitors. I have crappy monitors. And not too happy about that. So I'm going to move some of this wheat over to where I'm moving the farms. I guess I can take out this. These were my small farms. And it's moving because these are too small for what I need to do. Plus, it's right next to my base. And I don't want big farms right here. And what I'm thinking of building down here is a horse stable. And you may be wondering, why a horse stable? Because I have been collecting horses lately, and I've run out of places to put those horses. And it's kind of annoying to hunt down horses all the time that you already own. So I am going to make some sort of stable somewhere that fits more than four or five horses, which is what I have right now. And what I'm talking about is this sucker up here. And the good old stick a horse inside this problem and they won't sneak out is fine unless you have more than one horse in there. Then they push each other, jostle, and they end up pushing a horse out. So let's get you back in. And just them jostling around will eventually push the horse out. So that's going to change. So I need a stable for each individual horse. Oh, look at that. I can see my stream, but I can't see the chat on here. I got my mobile device up, and it is actually showing that I am streaming. But I want to be able to see where the chat is. But I don't know. Chat? Get the chat app? I don't need the chat app. Well, I guess maybe I do need the chat app. Oh, it's dark. Let's go take a little nap because I don't want things to blow my crap up. Oh, and I got my voice on there too, so I gotta turn down my volume on this device. Hold on. Volume down. So what type of oak? Those were spruce fences. I don't want spruce fences at my thing. So I have a Kindle Fire next to me, and I'm looking at that, and I'm showing my stream, but I don't know where to get the chat on it. I'm useless when it comes to new devices, because I'm an old fart face, and old fart faces don't know new stuff. So you're going to have to bear with me. If you come in the chat and say hi and it takes me a second or two to answer, or maybe a minute or two, bear with me. It's not because I dislike you or anything. Hello, creeper. Guess what? Burn. So let me show you where I'm moving my farms to. I should actually come over here and destroy these. Get rid of this water. How did that happen? I picked up water and put it down at the same time and duplicated the water. I didn't realize until recently how many bugs are actually in 1.9, but there seems to be a ton. So that, you know, I'll just deal with it. I think the reeds are going to go, and these animals over here, they're going to the new place also. And thankfully, the new place is just right over here. There's my pot of gold. Bear with me, I stole some of that gold to put up a 7th beacon somewhere for my super secret project, which has used 7,000 obsidian blocks already. And we'll probably be using another 20,000 obsidian blocks by the time I'm done. That's why I'm starting it now, even though the video is probably not going to be coming out until about Christmas time. So yes, I'm putting about 8 months of work into a video for my 50th episode. And I hope it's worth it. It should probably be worth it. I am right now in the process, I got the beats from the end, and we'll be traveling to the end so I can do some menial tasks to help me in my endeavor to do my 50th episode of Jams. Oh, come on. I forget. I'm not in jumping land. Oh, my gosh. Jump like a boss. There we go. Took long enough. So, that's what we're doing. We're just trying to expand these farms. I should put my sword in my other hand. That's a looting sword, and I'm pretty sure with a looting sword and you're offhand and you're doing things like this, it'll give you more seeds. But if worse comes to worse, it doesn't. Well, at least I got a looting sword in my hand, so I look cool at good. You know, especially seeing that it's flashing between purple and blue and all that other stuff. And I'm just playing the Minecraft music, which is kind of interesting to me because I never listen to the Minecraft music when I'm playing. So it's kind of like, wow, what is this? Oh yeah, that's right. It's C418, which is somebody I do like and recognize. Let's see. So I gotta get some more carrots done. I should just go get my bone meal that I had before and just finish these up so I don't have to worry about covering all the spaces. But when you have the bigger farms like this, you can definitely get more supplies for when you're trading with villagers. And for those not in the know, I guess I'll show you my villager area so you know what I am talking about. No, you don't. Oh, yes, you do. So, I also was thinking of bringing in a mycelium farm over here. So basically, you can make a square and put a mycelium block in the middle, and it will change all the other grass into mycelium. But I think I'm just going to go and hunt and just take out a whole bunch of dirt from the Mushroom Island biome so I don't really have to worry about it too much. So where are my... There's my seeds. I gotta bring all my stuff over here. Just kind of a pain. One of the worst things about this game is when you do a project and you start getting chests everywhere and then you want to clean up from it because you, or at least I don't like having things sitting around. You know, you complete a project and months later there's a couple of chests still sitting there from the project. It's not something I really like to leave out. So when I finish a build, I try and get all the chests out of the way. Hold on. Excuse me. I still don't know where the mute button is on this without making a lot more noise, so once in a while you'll hear me cough like that. I am getting over a cold and surgery. The two don't work well hand in hand. So let me do some of this wheat because I'm gonna bring a whole bunch of animals over here. This is loud stuff. Yeah. I can imagine, you know, nobody knows who I am on Twitch, and here I am streaming, and I'm just doing farm everyday BS that isn't really all that exciting. It's not like I'm going to be fighting the wither or anything like that in here, but this is the grindy part of Minecraft that usually never sees the light of day in videos. And I was thinking of streaming a lot more and doing the grindy parts, but I am still kind of at a loss of what I should do, if I should even bother playing Minecraft on YouTube or Twitch at all, because I'm a busy person. I work at a job I don't really care for at all. I'm not looking forward to going back to the job. And I would really love to be able to self-sustain doing things I enjoy, including this. But that is really quite unrealistic, seeing that I made over $60,000 last year, and I have no money to my name whatsoever right now. I live way outside my means, not on purpose. So I would have to do very well to do this as a living. The only thing I can really think of is possibly getting a small part-time job like I used to, like delivering pizzas and having all day to just record and put up a couple episodes a day, stream for a couple hours a day, and hopefully with donations and just people liking the content of the material, it would get some money in my direction, but not the type of money that I really need to raise my family. But you know, my dream would be to do this because I really love playing this game. It's not a game that I get bored of pretty easily. You give me a mountain and a shovel and a stone pickaxe and I will have fun destroying that mountain, because finishing the project is pretty awesome for me. There we go. So now it says there's two people watching, and that's me, both on my mobile device and my computer here. Not a big deal. Let's go and put this stuff away, and I will show you something else that I need to be doing. At least we're getting some wheat. Oops. Let's see. I don't know if that right there was a big, let me check something out. I don't know if that's going out on stream or what, but it says I have no lost frames, so I think I'm doing okay. I'm getting some weird headphone buzz in my headphones, and I don't particularly care for that, but I don't think it's going out onto the stream, so there was another pop. Pop. So I have sheep, pigs, like you, and cows to bring over here. And I was kind of thinking of making a farmhouse up here somewhere. But this would be a perfect place for pastures. So I think I'm going to make a pasture of some sort. And let's see where the first one should be. I'm going to close it in with fences, and I think I'm just gonna cut down a couple of these trees and just continue the path that I began with the produce farms that I've already made. So this tree is in my way, so it's gotta go. Goodbye, tree. Been nice knowing you. Did I just kill part of another tree? I don't know. Doesn't matter. And it looks like I need to go to sleep because, you know, I'm not one that enjoys being awake at night. I'd rather sleep the day, nights away. So here we go. There's my bed. I did move one over here. This is my bed from my other stable. Because once this project is done, until I build the house inside, over there for the farms, the farmhouse, I will just use that bed in the middle of the field. We can call it roughing it. We like roughing it, don't we? Roughing? Rough and tumble? Roughing? What's up with this? Sometimes the leaves are touching and they won't despawn, so I'm going to kill that tree also. I'm gonna even this out a little bit. First, where's my shovel? Shovel. And clean out some of this. Get it back. We need to clear this out pretty well. Thank God for efficiency 5 shovels. And we're gonna put on the fence. And get some animals over here. And that's what we're doing. Yeah. And again, I would like to say I don't have access to chat unless I pause this game and look over. I cannot play this game on minimal mode where I can, like, have chat on the side of my screen, and I don't have multiple monitors. So it's a little tough for me to get chat, and I'm kind of upset that this thing's not working with the chat. Let me see what it's showing me over here now. I'm turning my Kindle back on. So we do stop going to that main screen. And it's not even loading up the Twitch thing. Let's see. Trending, no. Twitch. Twitch KMA's Corner. Let's go to Twitch KMA's Corner. Are you going to Twitch KMA's? No, you're not going to Twitch KMA's Corner. Oh, let's go now. There we go. So let's fill in some of this dirt. Oop, or that's not dirt. That is called a little pond. I'm sorry, but you know, when you walk around the wild, you really have these little ponds everywhere in the middle of plains. It's kind of annoying that they have all these little ponds in the plains, but yeah, maybe it happens in England or wherever these people are from that made the game. Yeah, I have to figure out a good way to get it so I can actually chat with people. This ain't cool that I can't see what's going on in the chat. So, say hi and I'll check it out in a second, see if anybody is there. Let's see what we got. Where are we? That's my OBS. Oh, come on, really? Well, anyways, I don't know. Let's hit play on that. It just took my Fire all that time to load up that one stupid thing. But we're almost there. Yeah, man. Sorry, little mushrooms. So, yeah. Seeing I've been out of work, and I usually work about 65, 70 hours a week, I've had like an immense amount of free time. So I've done a super duper amount of stuff in this world. And most of it has not been seen on video yet because I want to just keep the videos on Monday. So like I say, if you see something that's not in a video and you follow my videos and you're going, Keith, what is that? That's what it is. See like that rainbow over there? Mm-hmm. Yep, nobody knows what that is. Not at all. I don't even know what that is. It's so new and exciting. Or maybe I did put it in video yet. I don't think. I think it's coming out this Monday on video. Because my last video was Snow Crash's Gold Farm. The fix he did for 1.9. And then, little to my knowledge, a week later he was going to release a new video with a whole new version of the farm. Wish I had known that before I made his old farm. But, no biggie, it gets what I need done, and as you see, I got 130 levels of XP, and that is from that gold farm. So, and I guess the revision he did is much better than the one I made, so we can't wait. I'm going to have to get some more dirt. There's dirt all over the place. Let's eat some food. Let's see. So the path would go like this. And I'm going to level this out so there's not a 2-drop here. And hopefully that will be enough dirt to cover up this hole. Let's see. You know, whenever you think you're going to do something in Minecraft and you go, well, I need about 30 blocks, and then you go and do it. It's usually about twice as much. So, you know, if you're thinking you need 32 of something, go get yourself like 64 of that something, or else you're not going to have enough. So this farm is getting a little bit bigger, and I'm going to probably move this crafting table at some point. Let's see. Do I have a shit? There. No. What do I want to do? I want to make some sticks. I don't have any sticks. So let's make a little. That's not going to be enough. That will probably do. And then we just go 32. Oh, I gotta do this also. Shoot. Git. Is that spruce? Yeah, it's spruce. Git. Okay. Now we make some fences so we can have a place to store our animals. There's some fences. And we also need to make a couple of more. Let's make 8 sticks. So we can go like this. No, that's not enough. We need 2 more sticks. Or 2 more sets of sticks. So 8 more sticks. So we can make 4 fence gates to get into this area also. So that's how you use a lot of wood in a short amount of time. And it's really not that much wood to begin with. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I usually put one of these. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2. Then this will be the edge. I like doing 22 because it's the same size of the other beautiful pens that I have made. So now I know I can get rid of this dirt. Get bye bye dirt. And where is the dirt? I started this stream with a full inventory. Not a smart thing to do. So we got one. Ever notice? Quiet. No sound. Gotta fix your game. No sound on torches. Sometimes no sound when you're placing fences in general. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Beat. Oh, not what I wanted to do. Bye. I want the fence gate there. Not there. That's for damn sure. Let's put the fence gate right there. Oh, so that's... We'll bring out this other thing so we know exactly where to go. The lining up having to be correct with where things are is imperative for somebody like me, because if it's off, it's going to bug me and it's going to make my life not miserable, but not as fun. And you know what? I like having fun. I don't like being aggravated when I see something that's off a little bit. And I know that's going to happen, so I'm just going to fix it immediately. So I don't have to worry about it in the future. Before I started making this, I was kind of upset because I was going to put a house and stuff right on the water over there, but that's not going to happen now because I have this farm that I got to make. And there's that. Woohoo! Still kind of bugs me that there's no sound with the torches, but I'll get over it. It's not the end of the world. Now, this is done. Wow, isn't that beautiful? It's like this brown like stuff put in order so it like makes a cage so I can cage my animals. That is simply brilliant. That's right, it's brilliant. So it is getting dark again. I'm running towards rainbow. Good thing it's not raining to make that rainbow. And I'm gonna go boink. I said I was gonna go. Hey, boink. I'm thinking of running back to my old texture pack. Or not the old texture pack, the regular texture pack that people use in 1.9. The default texture pack, because I don't know, I have a love-hate relationship with the clouds and stuff. Yes, it looks beautiful, but I don't want my game to be too... How do you call it? Shush, sheep! I can even hear your footsteps in there. I don't want it to. When I create a world, I don't want it to look different than what other people would see the world. So, this is the stable I was thinking of making down there. Putting two of them together and throwing it down there. But why would I need, what is that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Why would I need 15 places for horses when I'm not even a big horse fan? I'm not a big horse fan at all. They're kind of a pain in the butt. But I gotta do something about it. What are we? We got that. We got some of these. Gotta always remember to put away your stuff. So I need to be a little focused and stuff. Another little secret thing I should tell you about is, check this out, you know? I got to myself a little dragon head. Didn't record any of that. People go who make YouTube videos going, oh, the dragon fight, and you didn't record it? Well, I guess I can have 7 more dragon fights if I wanted to, and maybe I'll record one of those if you guys are interested. But dragon fights are pretty effing boring. They're not fun. I mean, they're fun, but they're not fun. They don't translate well over to YouTube videos, so be it. And I've also upgraded my food to golden carrots, because that's the way to be. So I made these for... I made this farm specifically because purple is one of my favorite colors. Everything I do in this world, if you don't know, revolves around the color blue or purple. Purple, blue, same sort of thing. And I just want to grab some of the fruits before I knock all this stuff down. So, seeing this is a new product in my world, I'm doing my best to grind out a couple of stacks, couple of chests worth of blocks from this. So I have all these... Mother effer. So I have all these blocks. So if I go and I'm building some project, I can just go, hey, you know what? I have a double stack of purple blocks and a double stack of obsidian. Why don't we just start using that for a build? And it'll be a while before I have a double stack of obsidian. Before the end of the stream is done, I probably plan on getting not a double stack, but a couple of double chest full of obsidian for my secret build, which will not be shown in the stream. That's gonna be saved for a video in the future. I guess I got enough of these stupid things. I'm supposed to get 16, but they didn't really fall in the right places. But I have a lot of extra chorus fruit that I can plant. So I just made 2 rows of 8, 2 blocks apart each, so I can just walk through here pretty quickly. And I made those platforms, which you can't really see from the other side at all. See, I got 15. Well, I was short by 1. And my inventory is so effing full. I can't believe this. Let's get rid of some of this shit so I can pick this shit up. Yes, I've gone to swearing because this ain't... I don't like having full inventory. And I've had a full inventory since the beginning of this stream. And it's kind of annoying. There we go. Collect all this stuff up. For the most part, when I have the blocks three blocks away from the actual growing pad, most of the stuff falls onto the pad itself. As you see, there's something over there that fell, but I'll live. I'll get a little wet and jump in the water and have fun with it. Let's see. Oh, a few of them fell in there. Not good. Not good. Off my game. I can't even get up there, can I? Let's see. Jump. So we throw a stack in there, a stack in there. A little bit in there. Move that down there. Now get the rest of my junk out. And that's it. Let's go and... Should we try and bring the cows over? Yeah, let's bring the cows over. I'm going to show you the inside of this because you're not supposed to see this. So keep your eyes closed. This is coming out in next week's video on Monday. Speaking of which, I have a video coming out tonight for Doom. But, yep, don't look. Nothing here, nothing to see here. No sheep farm. Yeah, I don't think you believe me. No pot of gold either. I have the six-sided beacon. The six beacon and one, which is 244 blocks of iron, gold, or diamond. Then I made another beacon in the end so I can collect obsidian with 164 blocks. So between the two, I got 400 and plus blocks of my ore trapped in specific places. Let's see, the best way to bring these cows over. So I'm running a little low on ore. Okay, I did cut out some of that and I got fences to fix that. Because moving cows with through fence gates and stuff, it's not exactly fun. So I just like to take out a whole side of the fences and just do it. Yeah, see, there used to be gold blocks that went up over here a little bit, but I had to steal those to make the beacon, which is kind of bad. But you know what? The beacon is necessary because when you're mining 70,000 obsidian blocks, you're going to want a haste beacon. And that's what my secret project is going to be. Using 70,000 obsidian blocks. Which is a little much. I know that. But it's going to be worth it, hopefully. And that is only... Those 70 blocks of obsidian only covers about 10% of the secret project. Let's just say my biggest build I'm probably ever going to do, or most annoying build I'm ever going to do on Minecraft, is not even going to be videoed until its reveal date, which will be in December. That's how big the project is. If I work on the project 3 hours a week, I will be done in December. Which, yikes. I keep dropping cows as I go. But that's okay. Let me see. Whatever. I gotta figure out a good way of doing the stream thing, because I would really love the stream almost every single day, but I am having some massive issues with stuff. Maybe people can help me. I don't know why I can't look at my chat on my Fire. I actually bought a tablet specifically so I can stream. I'm gonna sit here because it takes like 5 to 10 seconds for them to realize I got weed again once I go out of their proximity. And here they go. Come on, guy. Look at me. Look at me. And, because I don't have two monitors, and I do want to be able to, like, talk with chat and stuff, and if I don't know when people are saying shit, how can I talk to you guys? So, write down in chat, if anybody is in chat right now, what I should do. I could make the Minecraft not full screen, but I don't want to spend my days dying and doing stupid stuff all the time because I don't play the game in a comfortable way. So when I play it in full screen, it's comfortable to me. I can do what I want. I can think properly. And it doesn't bug me. So, moving cows is such a pain. I should just kill the rest. I got a pretty good amount here. And I hope that those static charges are not going through on the stream also. But we'll see. This is kind of still testing out the waters. And hold on, guys. I'll be right back. Excuse me. I'll tell you, when you have abdominal surgery, then you catch a cold and you have stitches all over your stomach and you start coughing, not a thing I really look forward to. Yeah, and the Kindle that I'm working with can't even hold the stream up right now. So I don't know how much of my problems right now is so much Twitch or how much of it is my end. So I'm just going to have to deal with it and say hi to the people in chat. Hi, how are you doing, guys? Gals? Hey. Come on. Yeah. You can do it. It's not that hard. Yeah, come all the way over here. I want you to be as far away from the exit as I possibly can get you. Okay. So let's see, I'm basically going to turn off my chat looker because it keeps freezing whenever it gets to Twitch. It plays for about 3 seconds and freezes, so I don't know. Goodbye, you piece of crap. Do you want to shut down your fire? Okay, I'll shut down my fire. Let me stand next to your fire! What the? Hold on 1 second. There we go. That was weird. That was very weird. I'm not sure what was really going on there. But it was weird. Come on. Come on. Why aren't you guys letting me out? This is a big batch of cows. I guess I should take this one slow. Slow and steady. Come on. Whatever stragglers don't make it now are gonna die. So, guess what? Be nice. Okay? Now here's Zombie. Hi, sheepy weepies. Keep pushing me around, guys. Yeah. I just hope now that these guys are going to be out of the way and I'm not going to see them too often. I'm not going to feed them enough. But I don't use cow meat as meat anymore. And I have probably 20 stacks of leather, so it's not like I need to worry about the leather. Come on. Come on, guys. We can do it. I'm still getting weird creaks and groans out of my computer, so let's unplug the fire completely out of my computer. Maybe that's what the problem was, because the fire was dying, and the plug I have is not close enough for my screen, so if I had it plugged into a wall socket, I would have to be like looking over my shoulder with a mirror and around the corner to see if somebody's in the chat. So, I apologize right now if there is somebody in chat. Let's see. No, it's just back down to me. How wonderful is that? But then again, you know, who the hell am I? I have no idea what this stream is actually labeled. I guess I should follow the rules of streaming, but I'm still like learning, you know? I don't have the right equipment, obviously. But I do think I can bring something to the streaming. Come on, guys. 3, 2, 1. Thank you. You gotta be patient when you're moving these suckers. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Like the cow. Like the meat. Like the wheat. The wet. Where are my things to block you in? We're gonna block you in and kill the rest. If you don't see your wives or your kid, I would be worried right now. Sorry. Let's go kill the stragglers. 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 There really isn't too many stragglers, is there? Lots of little biggy wiggies. But not many stragglers. Here's one. Bye. Bye. Oop, missed. Hey. Oh, I don't think I have fire aspect on this, so I don't think I'm getting cooked meat, am I? No. I don't usually put fire aspect on my swords because then you just end up lighting yourself on fire half the time. And I don't like lighting myself on fire. It's no fun. Alright, so we got some meats. These are also going over. This is going over. This is coming out. Oop, another dead man. Dead man. Oops. The sugar cane's going over also. Let's get rid of that. I'm going to pick up my fences. So I'm still trying to figure out exactly what I'm going to put over here. I just know I wanted to get as many animals and stuff out of my spawn chunks because I got some stuff going on in spawn chunks that super lagging. Well, I haven't really had a problem yet, but eventually I will have a problem with the lag on it. So let's... Oh, I can't run because I'm hungry. You gotta remember to always eat. Yum, 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 yum. Okay. So, I'm gonna put away this extra wood that I had made. And I'm not going to bother moving the rest of those animals just yet because I like the little variety right now. So I'm gonna put away the stuff that I want to put away. I got spruce. Did I put away spruce in here? No. There's the spruce woods. I got plenty of spruce fences and fence gates and stuff. And as you see, I have a chest for almost everything in this world. Let's go into my storage unit. The actual surprise thing that I'm building is kind of a storage unit. A pretty overdone storage unit, but what do I have? Let's just go down. Here's my small storage unit. There's some more leather. Gonna throw some dirt over here because I don't want my inventory filled at all. I got my grass blocks over here. Stone! No, that's not stone. There's stone. I don't think I have a place for this type of clay yet. Or I should put it with my other clay, but meh. That's good enough wood to keep with me. Fire, eh. Don't need that. The chest is full. And I have a hoe. Let's run out to that farm one more time, then we're gonna go on a little trip. Trips are fun. So yeah, for those of you who don't know why this beacon is totally stupid, don't need it. It has 6 beacons down there. So basically I have level 2 on all the things, and you don't really need that. It's a waste of time. It's a waste of money. But you know, I'm not a person who normally uses beacons. So I thought it would be fun just to overdo it for a couple episodes, and when I need beacons other places, I will tear it apart. But then I needed a beacon someplace else, and I decided, now I haven't showed my 6 beacon thing on a video yet, and I don't want to take it down before the video is out. So, yeah, it's staying there. So I took every single little bit of ore I had left and focused it all on, you know, making another beacon. So I have like no excess diamonds other than the emergency diamonds I keep near my near my enchanting table when I need to enchant stuff. What else do I need to leave here? I need to make another double chest for the cows. Actually, I should make 2 double chests, but I won't. I'm just gonna put one down. I don't like to mix my chests up with stuff, so when I say I need 2 double chests, it's basically because one for the cow meat and one for the leather. So there's one for the cow meat. Another thing I like to do, and I don't know, it looks kind of cheesy, but it works for me. I like to level off the edges. I don't really make it look terraformed, so to say. I just get rid of it, so... Oh, how you doing there? That is alright, actually. Not you, though. You can stay there. So when you leave, you don't have to do a double jump to get out. So I like to get rid of anything that has too high, so you can't jump up it. If that makes any sense. See, all this is one high there. It looks kind of cheesy. It doesn't look natural, but it's a farming area, and you can do that for the farms, I guess. I guess I should build Farmer John's home here, but not yet. So there's my beautiful blue moon. So, we are going to go and go for a journey and collect some stuff. I want to get rid of a little bit more inventory before we go. And I'm going to do the seed in here. And get rid of some of this dirt and stuff. Do I need any of that stuff where I'm going? No. So the next part of this little journey we're taking. Yeah, this little journey. Uh-huh. Is going someplace special. Place I don't spend much time in ever. Actually, I should harvest those things one more time because they are brand new and I want to make sure I get enough of those. And I forgot to leave my hoe over there. Mumbo Jumbo would be very happy with me. There's my diamond hoe, and I've used it almost all the way down just to make those farms over there. Are you proud of me, Mumbo? Yeah. Mumbo, leave a like in the description. Oh, wait, this is probably not going on YouTube. Well, who cares? Mumbo's a little too health nutty for me anyways. Same with Exuma. Oh my gosh, I didn't realize he was such a health nut until recently either. You know, Mumbo's one of those people you ask, so how was your day today? Oh, it was good. I ran 6 miles today. It was a little short, but, you know, 9 yesterday, and I guess I could do better than that. And I go, well, I don't think I've walked 9 miles in the past 20 days combined. Yes, that's a little jealousy. I'm not a health nut. I guess he goes out a lot and does his stuff, but he's got his home now. And he says he's going to change up the way he records, so I'm kind of interested in that. But I do, hate to say this, I like Exuma's videos much better than Mumbo's. But I like Mumbo's a lot too. Mumbo Jumbo. I like his sense of humor. But I do respect Exuma. Exuma's more like me, I think, other than the fact that he's also a health nut. But, you know, we can't fault him for wanting to be a healthy guy, jeez. I'm the one at home from surgery from eating like crap, so, you know. I guess I should keep my mouth shut, huh? Judging people. Fat person judging a skinny person for wanting to be skinny. Not cool. Let's see. There we go. I love the sound these things make when they blow. And I kind of wish these purple blocks were the darker color. You see on the edge here, kind of like the Minnesota Viking color. I think the purple blocks would have been much better if it was darker. But they also need... I understand why it is lighter, but still. I think a darker, or maybe even being able to add different stains, or maybe cooking it with something will give it a different shade. I think that might be something to look forward to in the future. But basically, I'm going to keep on harvesting these things until I have this thing filled with all these purple, which means I'm going to have to get some more coal over here, which is no big deal because I'm not one that skips over coal when I mine and stuff. Damn it. This is going to bug me if I hold on to it. So I'm going to run over here one last time to get the hoe in so I can use it when I trample these crops over here. I'm going to jump. Yeah, like on the beacon I have jump boost too. Yeah, it's nice to have, but it's kind of annoying. I think the perfect beacon would be just regen and speed. So, yeah. So let me know where you think I should stick the house. I might just stick the house in this area to overlook these farms. But I needed to make these farms bigger. A hoe should go right in here. I'll put it in the top one. Now we can drop off the last stuff, which is on the way to where I want to go next. So I need some stuff. And you can see what I do. Oops. To get the obsidian that I need for this secret project. And you'll be kind of amazed at what I've done already, I'm pretty sure. Maybe not amazed at the abilities of what I've done, but the amazement of the stupidity and the slapping at bricks for hours on end. Oh, didn't quite make it. Oh, I actually run faster than swim when I'm underwater. Did not know that. So I need to go downstairs again. Brown. Pew. Let's see. Oh yeah, another thing I should show you, and I haven't even played with them really yet. Elytra. I put on breaking 3 on there. I threw it in there because I want to get mending on there too before I start playing with it too much. As you might have heard, if you play with it too much, it might need some mending. Excuse me. When you covering from illness, water is a good thing to have. So I showed this area in video with all my villagers and what they have, and here's my mending guy right there. I need, I think, 20 of those to get it, but I'm not going to do that right now because I'm kind of afraid of the elytra. I want to get a couple more elytras, so when when I actually lose the elytra, it won't bother me so much because I'll have another pair. So where am I going? Ah, I'm going over here. Yeah. I got everything. I don't want this wool on me. I want my stuff basically as clean as possible. Don't want anything extra on me. So, let's go to the end. That is our trip. This is the end. My only friend, the end. I should show you the other thing I was doing. Maybe when I'm done with the end, I'll show you my Wither Skeleton Farm. Another thing that I made without people knowing. Yes, I have a Wither Skeleton Farm. It's how I was able to get the 21 Wither Skulls for the beacons. Let's see. Here we go. This is my stronghold base. But I didn't even find a library in here. But let's go. Bye. So this is the end. And you'll see the pillars up there. And this is what I've been doing to the pillars. I've been mining them down. Are you mad at me? You are mad at me. Come down. Bro. Bro, I'm right here. Come on. I'd shoot you with an arrow, but you wouldn't shoot back. Okay, I'll come over here so you can get me. Just don't knock me off the edge. Yeah. Oh. I think I pissed off another person, too. No. Only one? Okay. So, yeah, here's my other beacon. And as you see, I use my diamonds and stuff. So, there is a tower. Or was a tower. There was another tower. That wasn't a tower. Here was another tower. And here is another tower. All these towers I have completely taken down. You see where the spots are up there? From that's where the top of the towers are. I've taken them down. I've used all this obsidian already. And I still... Oh, shoot. I don't have any... And I still have to... We'll just use wood to climb up there. I'm still less than 10% of the obsidian I need. So I'm going to have to kill the dragon probably 3 times. Maybe 4 times to be able to harvest all the obsidian I need. And you got to remember, I've harvested 2 double chests of obsidian before I, let's see, which pick is this? Okay. I used up 2 double chests of obsidian before I started this idea of let's go to the end and I can kill the dragon and just harvest this obsidian. So this is basically what I've been doing for the last few days. I'm just sitting here, clunk, 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 clunk. And it does work a little bit faster with the haste too. It's only 1.5 seconds per obsidian compared to what obsidian can be, but it's still a pain in the ass. It's not fun. And as you see, I think it's over there. There's my first tunnel into where I could get the elytra and stuff, and I didn't do any of that on camera just because you know, I got sick and I started recording, and after about a week of recording I was for a whole month ahead. And it's like, well, you know, I have videos coming out in 2 weeks where I'm still in like 1.9, and it's like I'm playing 1.92 now, and I'm talking about things that happened a month ago by the time these videos come out. What that noise was, but anyways, it's not I don't like being ahead like that, so I stopped making videos and started working on this secret project a little bit more. But you know, as things go, you can't work on the same project for 3-4 weeks straight without getting a little nutsy. So I've been doing side projects and just not really recording them at all. But, and this is part of what it is. This is, I would say, the last 2 weeks I've been spending 3 to 4 hours in the end just doing this a day. Yeah. It's fun. And I can, like, make it a little interesting and go, like, you know, options. Let's see, video settings, shaders, and let's put on shaders. But shaders, in the end, don't look good. I mean, oops, back to game. Look, it's dark out. I mean, that looks pretty good. But I can't see a damn thing down here. And the weird purple-pink color of the obsidian, I don't know. And with the pickaxe being bright red or bright, shaders and the end don't work. It's just too dark, too weird. So, I don't use it. I mean, my frame rates are okay with it. It does the job, but I'm not a big fan of shaders in the end, right? Right. Done. And then I was going to go back to using the default texture pack. Because I made a banner. I haven't even shown that on camera yet. And the banner looks a hell of a lot better in the default texture pack than it does in the Faithful 32 that I use. And this Faithful 32 is still the one made for 1.8. So there's some things with it that are a little off, but I don't really mind because I'm playing this for my own fun. And that's the thing, is like, I look at other streamers and go, well, you know, it would be fun to stream for like 8 hours a day and do that as my job and have a second job to supplement my income a little bit. And that might get me to make 2/3 of what I make now. And I'd be doing things that I would enjoy instead of the job I really can't stand. As a matter of fact, it's a week away from the time that I go back to work, and my stomach is already not worried about the reception there. Even though, give you an idea, I've had surgery, people, and when you miss work at my job, people have to compensate for the loss of what you do. And even though I work in a job where I'm lifting 70 to 100 pounds constantly, and I'm not supposed to lift 5 more pounds, anything over 5 pounds, for 6 weeks. These people are sending me evil Facebook messages, blocking me on Facebook because they think I'm a selfish prick for being out on surgery, where it's a surgery that I would eventually kill me within a month or so. So they're pissed off that I saved my life and I'm missing work. They think I should be at work, possibly rip and open my abdomen by lifting up hundreds of pounds when I'm only supposed to lift up 5 pounds, and they're all being jerks about it. So I'm not really looking forward to going back to work. So I'm kind of thinking of alternative ways I can make money. And I look at somebody like Slind, who is somebody I like to watch on Twitch, and he has a daily sub goal of, like, it can be 7 or 11, depending on the time of the month or maybe the which day of the week. And every day, even though he does stream about 6 or 7 hours a day, he gets his 7 or 11 subs. And initially I thought, well, $5 per sub, you're getting 7, that's only $35 a day, 8 hours. And that's only $4 an hour. There's no way I can possibly do that. But then what I didn't realize was that at the same time, he gets donations of about $2,000 a month. So, say We'll just say $40 a day for the subs times 7 is $280. So we'll just round that down to $250. And you time that by 4, you got $1,000. So he's making about $3,000 a month just streaming. Not t-shirt sales, not any other side projects that he possibly might have. And you believe it or not, those side things are the ones things that you make the most money on. So I'm thinking in my head, well, you know, he makes about $3,000 a month, which is about two-thirds of what I do. But, you know, I would rather give away $1,500 a month and do something I enjoy for less amount of time than working at a job I can't stand with people I can't stand doing work I can't stand. So I'm really, really going, damn. If I was single and did not have a kid and a wife, I probably would do it immediately because, you know, I can struggle. I have no problem struggling. But I don't want my child to struggle and I don't want my wife to struggle. But still, my job is killing me mentally, physically, emotionally, and all that. And it's really not worth it anymore. So I'm keeping my options open. I haven't moved the dragon egg yet. That's going in this new building that I'm building that's using all this subsidy in. So, that is the cusp I'm at. And plus, Slend is somebody who's been doing this for a while. It's not like I'm going to start Twitch. You know, like if I started streaming 8 hours a day tomorrow on Twitch, started a new world, you know, started fresh and brand new and did whatever. It's going to take me a year or so of massive marketing. So I might get donations per month of up to $2,000 and so forth. So there's no guarantee that people would want to watch me. It's not like I'm going to be doing, I don't know. It's just my world is a little upside down right now, and I would like to find a good way out of it. I'm sick of not having fun in my life, and I want a way to have fun in my life and make money at it too. And for the last decade, I've been working 65, 70 hours a week for nothing. Because we're broke. So it's Thoughts. Deep Thoughts by Keith. That's what my name is. It's Keith. Nice to meet you. KMA is actually my initials. It does not stand for Kiss My Ass, but that's part of the reason why I chose it, because KMA could stand for Kiss My Ass, but I kind of wish I chose a different name, because half the people who see my name in chat call me KMS. There's that weird shit going on again. I don't know if that's normal YouTube music, 418 music, because I don't normally listen to his music, so I don't know. Let's just see this, if the stream's going okay. I've dropped nothing. So, no streams dropped. I've been streaming for an hour and 20 minutes. Doesn't seem like it. But I guess taking down these walls is fun. It's fun. It's a little fun. So how, maybe I should do a stream one of these days. Guys, first stream helped me out. It's not legitimately my first stream, but I mean, I had a first stream a couple of weeks ago and I uploaded that. This one is not a first stream either. Before the one a couple of weeks ago, I had done like 15, 20 minute streams just to test the waters and stuff. So it was actually my first longer stream. And this stream has already gone longer than that. So how much obsidian do I have right now? To give you an idea, that might make a ring around the building I'm building. And give you an idea, the building goes to height limit. So, yeah, I need to mine what I just mined another 200 times. But thank God for haste. So, what is up with the year 2016? What is going on? 2016 has seen the loss of so many people. The big one for me was David Bowie. David Bowie interlinks with a lot of the music I listen to. I'm not so sure I would say I listen to David Bowie all the time or anything like that. But some musicians that have played with David Bowie are in some of my favorite bands. And some of my favorite music of all time is David Bowie music, even though he's one of those people, when he releases an album, I have this little test I have for different people. When he releases an album, say there's 10 songs on the album, there'll be 2 great songs on there, 5 mediocre songs on there, and a couple of like, ugh, what's this going on? So I don't normally buy his albums because, or I used to until I realized that fact and I stopped buying them. There's a certain few albums that I like a lot, like his Low Badger, I think it was called. It's the Sound and Vision days, the late 70s, when he became a little experimental and he was working with Robert Fripp from King Crimson. And Aging in Blue, I think, was working with him at the time, and that was before it was King Crimson. Philip Glass, a classical composer that I was lucky enough to meet in Boston, invited me down to see his premiere of the Low Symphonies, which is symphonies he wrote based on David Bowie's music from Low. And so that's my realm of stuff. And so losing David Bowie, even though I didn't really care for most of his pop music, some of it's really good. One of my first favorite songs of all time was Let's Dance from the early 80s, but music like Space Odyssey and Panic in Detroit, love that song. There's a lot of really good stuff out there that he's done, and unfortunately there's a lot of crappy stuff he's done in the past. And even the last stuff that he made, Black Star, very experimental. David Bowie didn't go, okay, so what can make me money? This will, so let me do this. David Bowie got, what am I interested in? Oh, I'm interested in this. Hey, Laurie Anderson, you're interested in this. Why don't you help me with this and do some sort of experimental sound collage of some sort? And that's the things I like about David Bowie. Because the music taste I tend to have is that if it's on the radio, most likely I don't really care for it. I'm not a big fan of it. I do listen to the radio. I do sing along with the Katy Perry songs and the Justin Bieber songs. But my favorite music is kind of experimental non-radio music. So David Bowie was a huge loss. Probably the biggest one of the year. And I just found out that Jimmy Van Zandt died this year also. Nice, big-time guitarist. At first, I was thinking it was Jimmy Vaughn, Stevie Ray Vaughan's bro. But it's kind of weird to find out that Jimmy Van Zandt died. Who else died? Somebody else died yesterday. I think Sonny Liston died yesterday also. Which was the day that Prince died. And what's up with that? I mean, I remember when I was a kid, I had like 545s, which are little records that you played at 45 RPM on your stereo. And I had only a few albums of those 45s because I was a kid, and you could get them for $250 to $399 a piece at the time. So I had David Bowie's Let's Dance. I had Prince's Little Red Corvette. I had Bob Seger's Blame It on the Moon, so I guess Bob Seger is going to be dying soon. That's bad. But I don't know. The rock stars that made it big in the 80s are not having a good time right now. A lot of people have died. And there's some big names I'm not even thinking of right now. I have a list somewhere of the people who have died since the beginning of 2016. And it's so bad that today is Earth Day. And I'm like, well, I hope the Earth makes it through Earth Day today, because, Jesus, 2016 has been taking the lives of everybody. But Prince, if you don't know, he is a strange character. I think everybody kind of knows that. But what people don't really know is he's a musical genius. He might not be a genius with... No, I'd say he's pretty much a genius with his music. If I had his genius ability, I wouldn't have made the music that he made. But his first album, much like the Foo Fighters' first album, was 100% recorded and sang by Prince. There's no other artists on that album. Not too many successful albums in the past have been recorded all by one person. And Prince has the ability, or had the ability, and the genius to do that. And there is a video that explains how awesome he is. And just a musical clip, there's a Rock and Roll Inductee Hall of Fame video, which he played with Tom Petty and a whole bunch of other people. And they play While My Guitar Gently Weeps. And I'm pretty sure, you know, Prince knows the song, obviously, because anybody who knows music well or is a musician has learned all the Beatles songs at some point. And While My Guitar Gently Weeps is one of those Beatles songs. And I'm hoping this music isn't louder than my voice. Let me just check on my levels real quick. What do you think? It's not bad. It's a little loud. I should probably bring the music down a little bit. Let me do it like this. Options, music. Let's bring it down to 25%. Because, you know, music is great. I'm actually having a conversation about it. But, I want it to be the background and not over what I'm saying. So I totally forgot what I was going to say about Prince. But anyways, he is a musical genius. And I don't throw that word out too often. As a matter of fact, I only give a few people that title. One of them is Frank Zappa. He's a musical genius. Don't like all his music, but boy was he a genius. And I mean, some of the best musicians in the world have a hard time playing a basic Frank Zappa song. But Prince, I don't know. They're kind of hinting that it's a drug thing, and it's too bad, because it seems like the more creative and more genius prone you are, the more drugs you need to take to silence the roar of the stupidity of normalcy in the world. I mean, there's a lot of stupid, bigoted people out there, and it's hard to live your life listening to a whole bunch of idiots that are talking propaganda out of their ass instead of actually talking about the truth, or even wanting to know what the truth, because what they hear goes along with what they believe, so that's got to be true, and so they just spread the lies and don't care about finding out what the truth is. And seeing that is really frustrating, and escape, you gotta escape from it, or at least I do, or else I'll pull my hair out, which I've already done. I'm bald. And I don't know, it's just, there's some really closed-minded people in the world, and it's tough to handle when somebody's lying to you and you know it's a lie, and you bring it up to them and they have no clue it's a lie, because some reporter on this TV show presented the fact in this frame way, so it seemed like it was framed in a way that was wrong and gave the wrong impression. So, I don't know. All I gotta say is, don't trust what people tell you. Go do the research yourself. Because The people who tell you the stuff that they want to tell you, like the media and stuff, are owned by people who want the world to be a certain way. So they're going to tell you stuff that kind of goes along with it. Now I'm kind of sounding like a conspiracy theorist, but for real, double check facts that you hear, even if it is on the news, because the news is a propaganda machine now. It's not a news site. You know, if I wanted to see the news, I wanted to hear, see about the stuff that is important to me, not Sarah Palin telling Bill Nye he's not a scientist and he's not qualified. Come on, really? That's kind of like telling, I don't know, Barack Obama that he has no clue but what it's like to be a person with a different, darker skin color. He lives it every day. Maybe he's in a little bubble because he's the president, but at some point in his life when he was a kid, I imagine he got backlash because he was a different color. So he, even though he may not see it as much now, but then again with the Republican accusations towards it, he does see it, because the only reason why the other side hates him so much is his color. And the reason why I say that is because, yeah, the people hated Bill Clinton really bad, but the hatred towards Barack Obama is tenfold. It is like, oh my God, let's hang him up over a branch type hatred, which I can't believe it. I don't know why I'm talking about this stuff. I don't want to be depressing you guys. I just want to be getting some of this obsidian. I appreciate you sitting here while I do this obsidian. So, seeing that so many people follow my videos and stuff so intently and closely, I will give you a hint of what's coming up on the series in the future, because I don't think people will retain the information too well. But I just started a series of Doom, the 1993 version of Doom. Actually, it's a 1995 version, which is called the Ultimate Doom, which is re-released of the initial three versions plus a new episode at the end. So it is basically the 1993 version of it, and I'm going through every single episode in those, and there's, I think, 36 of them, and I'm releasing them once a week, so they'll be done around Christmas time. And I might continue with the Doom series, depending on how popular it is. Depends also on how well a new version of Doom 4 is coming out, and if it's any good. But it really looks like it's not even Doom anymore. But there'll be some excitement around the Doom trademark, and I'm hoping that some of that will relay over to these older videos that I am releasing. Because when I was a kid, Doom was the second game I played that caught my interest. I played Wolfenstein first, then Doom kicked its butt way better. And it was probably the first game where I would play for 8 to 10 hours straight on a regular basis and really enjoy finding all the secrets, getting my goosebumps on my arms and getting scared. A little bit more obsidian. So this is what I've been doing lately. I'm tearing down these towers. And as soon as these towers are done, I'm going to respawn the dragon and make some more towers and tear those down too. But I got to move my beacon before I do that. So remind me, guys, before I kill the dragon a second time, to remove the beacon. Because he'll just make those diamond blocks go bye-bye in one swell swoop. And there's, oh God, 12 stacks of diamonds in there. Don't use diamonds that much anymore because of the mending enchant. Great thing to have. Anytime my tools start getting yellow, I go to my gold farm and stand at the top of it for about 3 minutes, and everything is back to 100%. If I were to try and repair these tools in a anvil, it would be way too expensive. So mending has saved the waste of diamonds, I think. Which is pretty cool. So yes, back to the series again. I started Doom, the Ultimate Doom, which is the first four episodes of Doom. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to do Doom 2 after that, which came out in 95 or 1996. Then there was a TNT Doom, which I've never played, Evolution or something like that. Evolution, I think it's called. And that will possibly continue the series. And then there's the Plutonium Experience, which is also another 30 to 40 episodes. So between the four sets of Doom series that I'm planning on doing one video a week, it's gonna be, let's see, it's gonna be, let's see, about 40, 40, 40, and 40. So 160 episodes once a week. So that's almost 3 years of episodes right there with Doom. So hopefully if I continue with this YouTube and possibly streaming, you'll be seeing Doom videos on my channel for a very long time. And now the other exciting thing that I'm going to talk about is I belong to a server called Athens MC, run by King601 and also with help by Slime. Slime the King? Really cool guy. He makes videos also. Athens MC is an offshoot of the Cohorts server. I guess if Cohorts ended, they decided to make this server called Athens MC. One day I was looking for servers and I posted on Reddit, I'm looking for servers. Anybody have like a Minecraft hermit type craft type place to play? Let me know. And King responded and said, hey, I got this server. And being the noob I was at the time, and I'm still pretty much a noob now, even though I've been playing this game for 6 or 7 years. Somebody's out to kill me. This might be dangerous. But anyways, I had a Wi-Fi setup, and guess what? And my Wi-Fi setup was so bad that I couldn't even play the game on online. So I'd get in, it would be lagging so bad, I'd open a chest and I'd wait 5 to 7 minutes before the thing would actually show me that I had opened the chest. So it was unplayable. I think I annoyed a whole bunch of people there because they wanted to hang out with me, and I ruined an event where they were sending a person up and modded up to the moon, and it was a big server ideal, and I show up in the middle of that not knowing that everybody is doing this, and I'm lagging so bad I can't even contribute, and it becomes the main thing. And it's too bad that that was my introduction. But these guys are really cool people, and they have a server called the Snapshot server, which does snapshots, obviously, of the new stuff that's coming out. And for 1.10, they're going to start up the Snapshot servers again, and I'm going to do a series when that begins. And Slime the King has been doing some secret CTM type map enabling command block stuff with secret mobs and whatever to insert into this 100% vanilla, which I guess should be now considered 99.9% vanilla map, where you can do little challenges on the sides, and it looks like it's really going to be interesting, and I can't wait to get on there, hang out with some of my old friends again, meet some new friends, make a new series. Where is this guy hanging out? You're upset at me? Sorry. So that is another new series that's coming out. That one will probably... Oops. Throw my pickaxe. That one's going to probably be coming out on Thursday. So right now I have my KMA's Jams on Monday, which is my main series, my single player series. JAM stands for Just Another Minecraft Series, because there's Minecraft is so oversaturated right now. You know, why not? Then the other Tuesdays, I haven't decided what I'm going to do yet. Wednesdays, I haven't decided what I'm going to do yet. Thursdays is going to be the Athens video. Friday is going to be the Doom video. Now, the other things that I have, and it's gonna either gonna be on Tuesday or Wednesday, is another super secret series. I already have about 5 hours of edited footage ready to upload to YouTube to start the series. I started recording it in January. I've probably got 5 or 6 episodes 100% completed. But I want to make sure I continue the series, so I'm waiting for season to end at work, where I have plenty of time to continue recording that. It is a Minecraft based, but it's a mod, and I'm not a big fan of mods, but I'm going to give an exception for this one because it's based around something that has truly changed my life in the past, from when I was a kid to even very recently. So that series will probably be started in a month or so on Tuesday or Wednesday. Then the other series I was starting is going to probably be one of two things. One thing I want to do is BrianLorgon111 does a weekly bingo challenge, and I want to at least make one video a week of those the bingo challenge. And if I wanted to, I could really split that into 2 days, because I do want a video every single day of the week. But right now, I think I'm just going to keep it to one video a day. And I was thinking for the second day, having some sort of chat-enabled video, or maybe a stream like this that I can just upload a stream on, say, Tuesday every day, where I'm just sitting around doing menial stuff like this and talking to you guys about life and opinions and getting a bunch of obsidian. So that one's up in the air. I'm definitely probably going to have one of the bingo series. The other modded series, which I'm not going to hype to you and tell you what it's all about, because the whole first episode is a episode based on trying to figure out what the series is, and if I tell you now, you're going to know before you even start the series. And at the very end of the first episode, the first modded thing happens, and it's like, oh my god, I can't believe. Yeah. So I don't want to ruin that possibility there by telling you what exactly it's going to be. So basically, to review, Monday will be my jam series. Tuesday will probably be my bingo series. Wednesday will probably be a talkie episode, whether or not I record it in the jams or on Athens. Thursday will be Athens, like a build series for real. And the Wednesday could be a talkie episode, like a stream like this also. Just something talkie, something I can record real easily and throw up. Friday is going to be the Doom series. Saturday, I don't know. I had it figured out at one point. I have something planned for Saturday. I think maybe Saturday, because bingo, the Brian thing he does every Friday, is basically he releases 2 bingo cards that you can do. And usually it takes 10 to 15 minutes of recording time for each of the 2 cards, and there's this master thing where you get 25 minutes to get as many things on the card as possible. Think bingo when I say card. So instead of numbers on the card, there are things like golden apples or a diamond block or cake or something, and you have to see how fast you can make this stuff, and the person who gets bingo and the quickest time wins. So there's two of those bingos each time, and then you have a 25-minute time thing where you get as many possible things as you possibly can on there. So initially I was thinking maybe I can do two of those a week because they're pretty quick and easy to record. And I want to make sure I still have enough time to create interesting episodes for my jam series. You know, this guy's going to die. I'm sorry. You're making too much noise. Oh, where are you going? Did you go up there or something? I hear you now. Oh, hi. Come back here, you jerk. You have pretty eyes, you know. Yeah, where are you now? Oh, hey. Give me at least two ender crystals. You can be good. Where are you? Oh. Look at that. I don't think I got four from him. I think I already had two, so I think he gave me the customary two that I like to get. Long talk about series. Let me just see if anybody is actually paying attention to the stream. Now it's just me. Hi. I love streaming these. I don't want to see that. I just... I just started trying to play my stream. I brought up Twitch and there I was and I'm like, okay, let's go. Why aren't I moving? So, and Sundays is going to be like a vlog day. Just a 3-4 minute, hey, how's things going? This is what you can expect in the future. Sorry, I goofed up here or whatever. So I do plan on when May begins, start unrolling it out so I have 7 videos a week. And hopefully I can start getting some traction and people get to start knowing me, knowing how bland and funny a bland person can be, or dry sense of humor, or whatever, I don't know. Get some people who just want to go to sleep in front of the computer and watch my streams or whatever. But that is my goal. 7 videos a week and a pretty quick amount of time. So how do you think this obsidian getting is? Do you know of a quicker way to get obsidian? I mean, yeah, I could set up a wither, but obsidians don't blow up, so I don't know. I got the efficiency 5 with the haste 2 going, and I think this is about as good as it gets. And it's too bad because it still takes too long to get obsidian. But, you know, if you are making something that is made out of a specific block, I mean, I could have made the place black wool and it would have been a lot easier. Excuse me again. I'm recovering from cold. But it wouldn't look nearly as good as obsidian. But even building the thing right now, it's about 30 blocks high. It's not as... the details I'm putting in it, it's really hard to see because it's all obsidian. But it's going to be amazing when it's done. And I'm telling you now in April, and you're going to have to wait 8 months. 8 months from now, you never know what can happen. Donald Trump could probably have started a war with Russia. We're all dead. I don't know. Maybe Bernie Sanders has won and the whole world gives each other a group hug and smokes joints. Don't know. Yeah, so I've brought it down from up there. And we got 39. We got 17 stacks. I'm going to say when I'm done doing this, I'm going to show you my wither farm area and show you what I've been doing there. Just so you can get caught up a little bit on what I've been actually doing and show you how I collect the wither skulls. It's not done. All these farms are really not done yet. They're done in working order. But they're not done in design. Like my Guardian Farm is done. It works 100%. Item filters work. All the tracks work. It collects all those things, 10,000 things per hour, but it doesn't look good because I haven't replaced the walls with what it's, designs and made my B-rolls yet. And when I get back to recording or catch up on my recording already, it's going to be focused more on the design of things instead of the making of huge ass builds. Because when you're trying to record an episode and you have a build that takes, say, 70, 80 hours of real lifetime to make, it's really hard to do that in video and show you the effort that actually went into it without just making everything a time lapse. And I don't have a second channel to like do the LAN settings and just open up two accounts on my computer and do a time lapse like that. The only time lapse I can really do is first person time lapse, where I'm just taking this footage and I speed it up as fast as possible and seeing that this footage is dark and against obsidian walls. It's not the most beautiful thing in the world. And if I were to tell you that beginning of the stream that we were going to the end and we're gonna take down a 50 block high, 7 wide obsidian tower, you would be like, yeah, fuck you. And that's why I have zero people watching me right now. So, but I don't wanna, Minecraft is really grindy and I just don't want to. Let's just take out the rest of these now. And it's not like I want to show the grindy parts on videos because that's no fun. What I end up usually doing is telling you for the first 10 minutes of a video, hey, this is what I made since the last video, then taking a day or so break before recording the rest of the video and having a couple of more buildings on and going, hey, this is what I built since the last video. And I kind of just don't want to get into that trap, which I've fallen into repeatedly. I want to be able to actually show you guys and designs and stuff. So I'm gonna do some of the bigger projects off screen, because who wants to see somebody dig out a slime farm for no reason at all? Well, not no for re no reason at all, but nobody wants to watch you dig out a slime farm for 3 hours or even give updates on it. I don't know. So if you have any ideas of what I should do with the channel, what you guys want to see, let me know. And also, I'm thinking of getting rid of this texture pack and going back to the default, or not doing any changes to it for when it goes to 1.10, or when Faithful 32 catches up to 1.9 properly. There are imitation Faithful 32 things for 1.9, but music is weird. I don't know if I like the music that comes on because it makes it sound like my computer's broken. So I might get rid of the extra stuff. You mean like my torches look different than anybody else's torch? I got that weird cross view thing that's not a plus. It's a weird squiggly design. And my XP bar is rainbowed. I might just get rid of that and just use the basic Faithful 32 texture pack with the Halcyon Days sky, which is a sky that I use that gives me the nice sunsets and stuff. So I don't know where I was going with that, but the look of my channel might change. I'm thinking of trying Faithful 64, but I don't know how big a change that is. And I'm also thinking of trying the 3D Faithful thing. So the images are 3D because I'm always into the 3D look. So let's kill a couple of more of these blocks, and I'm actually down to level now with the ground. But if you look at the other one, and I don't know if you've ever fallen out of the world in the Nether, I mean in the end, these pillars actually go 20-30 blocks under the islands too. So I can legitimately dig this obsidian all the way down through the island, then have 20 or 30 blocks underneath it where I can keep getting obsidian, but I don't want to be under the island. The end scares me enough because of the void space, not because of the Endermen. Endermen, yeah, they can be scary sometimes, but you can deal with them when you know how to. And I got my water on me, and that's good enough to protect yourself from any damage an Enderman will do for you. So, let's just get these last pieces. Somehow, I am filled. What do I want to drop? Because I am just leaving obsidian underground now. What is least important? I guess I'm going to have to get rid of those. I eventually will be building a ender farm down here. But you know what works really well? Surprisingly well, especially with looting 3. Just making the Enderman the too high thing that you can hide underneath and just look at Enderman and have them come at you. I'll show you what I mean in a second. Okay, so this one is good enough. Let's see. This is my out. See, I got an Enderman thing over here. Where you can just be underneath and stare at a whole bunch of Endermen, and it's safe. They're not going to come down here. I mean, and you can get a couple of stacks of Endermen, Ender Pearls real easily with a looting 3. It's not as productive as the other, as an Enderman farm, but it's a lot easier. Especially with the, they're actually able to hit me. I like that. I guess I gotta learn how to stand in the middle. But I have such oppressive armor on me that nothing can really kill me unless I fall in the lava without a fire resist potion, or I get overwhelmed, which has happened. The Ender Dragon killed me a whole bunch because there's this ability of it throwing you way up in the sky. So, like, if I get rid of one of these, I just got almost a stack of Ender Pearls in 30 seconds there. So that's pretty, it's not as fast as an Enderman farm, but it's not bad for whatever. So I don't know where the last place I slept was. So this might be a bad thing for me to go through right now, because it might end me up in the secret project. And if it does, I'm going to run away as fast as I possibly can. Where am I? Okay, I'm over here. Thank you. No secret project here. And it's breakfast time. Yay. Hey, Piggy Wiggy. Good thing I'm not having bacon for breakfast. So, yeah. And I was gonna... I'm gonna get rid of these obsidian. And I'm gonna, see, it's odd. Oh, did I not put down any fruit? What happened there? I forget to put down the fruit before I left. What a nincompoop. Sorry guys, I'm gonna put down some fruit real quick, because I want to make sure I got stuff growing here all the time, because I am short on purple blocks. And even though everybody makes fun of these blocks, I think they're pretty cool. Purple happens to be one of my favorite colors, and it was before Prince died. And by the way, I think it's rather awesome that, excuse me, Wheezy's, that all the people are putting purple lights on as a thing for him. Like the Empire State Building, the different places around the world. I think that's pretty cool. But in the grand scheme of things, David Bowie's loss was much bigger than Prince's loss in my eyes. Let's see. Okay, so let's go and... Yeah, I got my thing. Show you my what I've done and explain the wither sculling thing. It's just platforms. It's nothing major. It's not like I got a wither farm or anything. Let's go in here and run to my temple real quick. Actually, I used the second temple because a lot of it was over lava, and it was easier to get more spawns when it's over lava. I feel like I go so much slower when I lose the speed. This tunnel needs to be done, which will be done on a video one day. This goes out to my Guardian farm eventually, and my mesa, and my actually two different mesas, my mushroom island, and my jungle, and that's all that's this way, but I still gotta make the tunnel for it. And here is the turnoff for the thing, and it's kind of scary because I got one high over a big drop into lava, and this is at... There's the temple. This is at what level? 115. So it's not often that you get to see the ground at 115. And believe it or not, this on this little trip here, that's not the only time I see the ground at 115. There's a little bit of that coming up over here too. Oh, nice thing getting ready to meet me. You can look down through there. It's kind of scary, and even a little hole there. But let me jump on this ladder real quick and kind of show you what I did. Because when you're farming for withers, it's nice to know that you're not going to fall off. So I'm just going to stop right here. You see, this is... I took out any of the higher buildings and just kept the platforms. You take out the walls on the side and add a slabs. Then two blocks above that, add fences so you can... stay on there pretty well. And you see that, oops, don't know why I was falling off. You see the spawners there, and there's a spawner back there also. I just turned them off for now. I have a double wither spawner farm. Well, I haven't made the second part of the farm yet. I don't know if I'm going to, but I do have a wither farm someplace else. But I think this is good because it's over a lot of lava. So I just come run up and go, hey, you know what? I don't like you. Die. And look at that. Skull. First time. I guess I should go skull farming all the time on stream. Because you get... I would say... Whoops. For every 100 you kill, you'll get 3 skulls. Then when just the blaze show up, I just shoot them. I got the power 5. Whoa. You kill that thing also. It's pretty simple stuff. You just gotta be careful. You gotta be prepared for these things. You gotta have your fire resistance right on you. You don't need to take the fire resistance with bad shot. Where is this guy trying to shoot me from? That doesn't matter. I don't see you. Hi, guy. I put these up so they can't, like, come after me. So I can just stay here and be safe. There you go. There's a lot of them somewhere. But I'll kill them in a minute. Hey, you run faster than me. Where the hell are you guys? One thing I hate about the nether. No, there's a lot of things I hate about the Nether. That's just one of them, though. Just so you know, I'm gonna get this guy. Yeah, you're hanging out where your things are spawning. There's Blaze. There you all are. That was the Blaze thing I'm underneath right now. All you need to do is make eight. But you can do three and around the whole thing. You know, count out three and block it in. Then go to the negative Z's to completely shut it down. But I just make it 9x9, just so I don't have to worry about figuring out which way is negative Z and doing it. And I'm not 100% sure it works that way. Come on out. You're right there. I know you are. And you just need to do it too high, and that will shut down the thing. And whenever you want to do that, take a fire resist potion, because they'll shoot you. The fireballs don't even hurt you. The only way they'll do damage with you, on you, if you have the fire potion on you, is if they actually hit you, like close range sword hit. Oh, you jerk. Which way are you gonna go? Far away? No, you're too far for me. I'm not wasting my infinity arrows on you. It's like whack-a-mole here. Oh, now they're just coming closer. So this is kind of what I do. They hit you with a thing, you only burn for a couple of ticks or a couple of seconds, so it doesn't really matter that they hit you. It's just you don't want to be hit multiple times in a row, and make sure you have plenty of food on you. You can also juke them too, but that takes a little effort. Not everybody knows how to juke. There you are. Where are you now? So I can kill you. It's also a good way to get gassed here is, I'm gonna be respawning the dragon a few times, so I'm gonna have to get the ender crystals, or the end crystals. I don't know where you went, mister. So, I'll explain to you how to really make one of these, real quickly here. I guess I could shoot the wither skull with the thing in my offhand, but I don't want to do that. Come on, die. Because I guess if I put this in my offhand and shoot him with this, I still get the looting. But I'm not. I'd rather just shoot him. I hit him with my sword. So here's the other spawner. Just 9x9 around at 2 wide. And just have the bottom plate right there. They can spawn at this level, one block underneath here, but their head would be in there, so they just don't. So, I'm going to go over here and show you what I do to make these platforms. So, let me go to an area over here. I'm going to do that same platform thing over here eventually. You take out these walls, and then you put the hash slabs on the outside here. And then I put the fence at this level so you can't walk off. Same thing over here. And when you got a covered building, you can extend it by one around the whole thing. But a place like this where there's a walkway without a covering, you can count out seven. So seven from the center. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then you can make a platform that goes 7 out, then 7 over there, so you can have this big area where they spawn. So then I line it with the half slabs again, and then put the fences in, so if I am attacked and getting overrun, I don't fall off the thing. So this whole area also, as you see, has a spawner there, a spawner there, which I can probably initiate both of them at the same time. But I'm going to half slab this, and it also goes into the walls and stuff. I really got to stop that lava flow. That lava flow really annoys me. And the reason why you want a big area like this is because sometimes you get overrun with zombie pigmans, with the entities. And if you walk away from the area that you're trying to kill Wither Skulls in, everything will despawn, and then you'll start anew, and you'll get better chance of getting Wither Skulls, so you can get, or Wither Skeletons, so you can get Wither Skulls. But like I said, I chose this because it's over lava, and that's a good thing, because then you don't have to worry about spawns. And what I don't like is when I walk away and I come back, and instead of being overspawned with Wither Skulls, they're overspawned with these stupid things. And I'm not a big fan of these stupid things, so I'll just stay away and just let me get down where I'm safe, because I can't fall off at all over here. So even if he messes me and wrecks me and throws me around a bit, I'm still pretty good. Stop flying. I also take the skeletons and try and shoot them. It sounds like there's somebody like next to me too. They're all underneath that. Kill the skeleton because he's more dangerous than these guys, I think. So that's what I kind of do, is I work my way slowly through the blazes. I was trying to break the fence because I was too close to it. And I collect up these blaze rods because you can make those pretty lights. The end, I don't even know what they call them, but they're pretty lights that you can get in the end. And I like them a lot. So then you need to make a place like this just every once in a while, just in case you are being overrun and you need to protect yourself. There's a guy. Where did I go? There's a guy down here. Let me get him. So that's what I do. It takes probably half hour, 45 minutes of me seriously scamming this place to get 3 skulls, which isn't too bad. But with the other side open, I should be able to cut down that time a little bit more. And I don't mind that it's open because, like I said, I like the gas tiers so I can make ender crystals, because you need an ender crystal and some other stuff. I've never made an ender crystal, so I don't even know. And even that like little runway is pretty good, because you can run all the way down there and it will declear all of this stuff. And I'm also thinking of putting in jump pads here, slime jump pads, so I can jump up there and do the same thing, because as you see, the guys I want to kill are up here, and I don't have any good ways of getting up there. I used to, but I kind of took it all down. So sometimes I can get the attention of one of those guys, but I shouldn't have to. There should be more spawns than what I'm getting right now. But Wither Skull hunting is definitely a grindy, patience type thing. You see, there's 2 skulls up there, and that's no fun. They should be down here. So that's why I want to add that section to this. So I guess, really, the stream, because I want to go build on that secret project, and I can't show you the secret project, so I think I'm going to end the stream. Oops, sorry, dude. Because I want to put in the floor. So now you know it's a building. It's actually going to be my main storage room. Because part of the goal of this series is to have a double chest of every single item that you can possibly have a double chest full. Including gas tiers. Can you imagine having over 1,000 or so gas tiers? Sponges? I mean, I have a whole bunch of... I have like 7 or 8 ocean temples I know the whereabouts of. This guy's wearing a mask. Hey, he's actually got one of my helmets on. So he's going to drop one right now. See? So that's 2, and I haven't really been trying. I forgot completely what I was just talking about. Damn. 420 is still left over in my head, I guess, even though it's 422. Boink. Oh, I totally missed you. When they're over there, I can just come over here and they come finding me. And I noticed, I found out the hard way, that if you take it strength 2 and you hit these guys, you can't one-shot kill them anymore. So you're shit out of luck. Let's see if I can get this skeleton a little too low. Can't tell. And I don't want to climb up there with a skeleton who's going to shoot me off. Well, I'll stick around to get one more skull. But I'm not happy with my spawn rates now. There's too many pigmen around. See, before I used to just kill the pigmen. Now, if I try, they're gonna be angry with me. These guys show up too often too, but I don't mind this because I need these guys too. Even though I do have a double chest of, oh, that's what I was gonna talk about. A double chest of all items. So the secret building I'm actually building is gonna be the main storage place where I'm gonna have the double chest of all items. So it's gonna be like 900 double chests in this building. So it needed to be a pretty big building to begin with. And it's gonna just be the overflow. It's not gonna be even in the center of my base. So if I'm running low on sponges and I need to get some sponges, I'm gonna have to travel a little bit in the Nether to get there, but it's not too far. It's about 200 blocks away from where I normally where I normally hang out in my world, so it's not the end of the world. Strange how the guy far away from me comes at me first. Nice. So, certain things I'm not going to get double chest of. Like, I'm not going to get a double chest of Protection 4 books, but I do plan on getting a double chest full of, well, I actually already have a double chest full of enchanted books. Double chest of fishing poles I've already got. Double chest of lily pads and vines, all the mundane stuff. The hard things, oh jeez, I don't know. Glowstone's gonna be hard to get a double chest with because I like to use it. Be no problem with the guardian stuff because I can get that in about 20 minutes of AFKing. So there's certain things like the armor. I'm not gonna be filling a double chest of diamond protection 4 pieces than getting a double chest of iron protection 4 pieces. Now it'll be just a chest of excess armor that I will collect probably through skeleton spawners and stuff, so it will be like a double chest of armor and not a double chest of specific types of armor, because you gotta draw limits somewhere. Can't get a double chest of dragon heads. I can get 7 or 8 of them, I think, maybe even 9. But then again, I saw 2 end cities and I only saw 1 ship with 1 dragon head, which is kind of annoying. So we'll see. You moved. So, you know, the rules will change a little bit as I go along, and hopefully 1.10 doesn't have many different biome changes, because I'm going to be upset with biome changes, because if they come up with a new biome and release, say, 1.11 has a new type of biome, I don't have that in this world, which means I would probably restart. Come on. Yeah. See, I got two skulls pretty quickly, right? Two. And a third one. When you're scamming for skulls, you can usually get them in groups. You'll kill like 40 or 50 nether skeletons and get none. Then you'll kill 5 and get 3. So that's kind of how it works. And I got one right away, and I got the second one fairly easily. I think I've only killed like 20 or 30 of them. And I said initially that if you kill 100, you usually get the full amount. Oh, here's some. See, I don't like fighting these as bad because sometimes you panic, then you jump on the edges, and then you fall off and over, and then you die. And I don't like dying. Even though when I did the dragon fight, I died about 25 times. Because I'm one of those, I did not want to lose my good armor, so I did the dragon fight naked. And guess what? It appeared to be. I had no armor, nothing great on me, and the dragon was able to... And this is a question. I don't know if anybody's actually going to watch this. If you have shitty armor on and a dragon throws you up in the air, they'll throw you a good 100-something blocks in the air. But if I noticed when I was wearing my diamond good armor, he wasn't doing any of that. When he threw me, I would throw like 20 blocks maybe. Where's the other guy? He's over here somewhere. He's right there. So even this intersection, I could do a big platform here because it's not a covered intersection. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go 7 that way and 7 that way, and it will be pretty good. Look at all these suckers. Too bad there's a skeleton there. I'm hoping there's a wither back there. I think there is. No, there isn't. So you see, I've been doing some work, and I haven't even shown you the work I've done to the Guardian farm, which is, I guess I'll give you a sneak peek, because I think that's the next episode that's going up next Monday, is the finished Guardian farm. I mean, working Guardian farm. So let me go run over there real quick. This is, I guess, other than the main secret 50, the project I'm going to unleash on the 50th episode that's using all the obsidian, I think I'm giving you a whole bunch of secrets of stuff I've already made. Which is okay, I guess. It's just a sneak preview into future videos. And I think there's 2 or maybe 3 videos that are complete and uploaded to YouTube. Right now, I'll probably upload this to YouTube tomorrow. What's today? Today's Friday. Yeah, it's a good Saturday video. Don't know how long I've been streaming, but hey, what are you gonna do? So, let us go. Die. Missed you again. Stop moving around. Thank you. Let's go check out the Guardian farm real quick, because I haven't been over there in a couple of weeks. That's how long it's been finished. Just one more run around just to make sure there isn't a wither head somewhere that I could possibly use. I can't believe I used to use these things for decoration. They're such a pain in the butt to get sometimes. But, you know, that's what you gotta do. I turn on somebody's stream, and I listen to their stream, and I just go around and grind on my world because... Oh! You're pretty fed up. The skeletons in the chainmail usually give me a hard time for some reason. I like to still get the now that's a juke. I still like to get these because I do go through my fair share of fire resist potions, and it's, I don't like wasting slime. I do have a slime farm, but it's not like I have more than a double chest of slime. So if I were to make those slimes in the blocks, I'd have like hardly anything. Oh, he's behind me. Where are you? Hi. I'll kill you now. Why don't you go over, get over, yeah. Now. Now. He dropped his gas tier down there, you jerk face. Yeah, I don't know what I'm gonna do with gas farms. You know, the best way I've had gotten gas in the past is making gold farms above the nether before I put a roof on it, and they just continually spawn. So maybe I'll do some sort of nether on top of the roof gas farm. Jeez, die. Please don't hit me. I need to eat something because I guess I'm a little low on health. I really like the fact that the health goes up real quick after you eat. Come on. Give me one more. I just want three. Nah, I just want three. I still got two. Screw it. Oh, these guys keep spawning. Need the bones. I waste so much bones and growing trees and stuff and things. It's like a fapping convention. Hey, that fap hurt. I really think the sounds that these things make are kind of gross. Okay, let's get the hell out of here. Should we run all the way to the... Yeah, I'm gonna run all the way to the guardian farm. Why not? Die. Oh, is he on my thing? Jerk. Many more skeletons. Skeletons. Nope. Okay, let's get the fuck out of here. And as you can see, I haven't cleaned up my glowstone yet out of here. Let's see what I got over here. Let's get rid of the excess crap. Add this. I got a shit ton of bones I want to bring back with me after I go to... I got all my potions in there. Throw that in there. Okay. Yeah, actually, I don't need any more of that. Let's go to the guardian farm, then I'm going to call it a day. I'm going to enclose this ladder, make this all look decent. Because, whoa. Whatever I was doing there, I was doing something stupid. Because this is out in the open and a gas can blow this up and make my life miserable. But I like to have all my tunnels up here because supposedly you don't see, you can't fall through. So these are all tunnels I'm going to have to make in the future. I don't know how I would decorate a Witherskuller farm like I do the other tunnels. I guess I would have to use netherrack and probably stone slabs to decorate it. But these will all be train tracks and stuff. And one thing I have to learn is I know that you can add redstone to train tracks and it'll change the direction that the trains are going. I'm going for a long run now, so bear with me. I'm going to do this because this is often... I like the way this looks. Video settings, shader. It's kind of creepy. I tried to make a GIF like this, and I really couldn't because I don't make GIFs usually, so... And all the ones I've made. See how freaking dark it is and the shader's on? But you go like this. I rather like this. This is like, oh my god, this is scary. It's almost like the long tunnel of wanting you. The pink's on the inside. Oh wait, what am I talking about now? I guess it wouldn't be square. But it is like kind of freaky when you run along like this. There's my thing to the Mushroom Island. I gotta make a path for that. And I've shown this path before in a couple of my videos sped up, but it's a long path, so I don't normally run it like this. Go bye bye. What's the next place? I think it's to the jungle. And the only biome I have yet to find, which is kind of pissing me off, because I have a stable and I want to put some of this in the bottom of the stable floor because it looks like poop. And that's Podzol. I need a Mega Taiga. And the closest Mega Taiga is in a direction I haven't made any paths to. And it's about 400 blocks in the nether. But I don't have Podzol, and that kind of really bugs the shit out of me. So I'm probably going to do that after I do the stream. Is just make a tunnel out to the Podzol. Click myself up a couple of double chests of Podzol and call it a day. And come back and never go back there again. Because... unless I do make a kingdom. What's down here? Oh, that's one of the mesas. Wait, did I just screw my way up? I did screw up my way. That should say... oh, man, I'm lost now. The mesa should have been on the left-hand side. So, yeah, there's a jungle. So I'm still going in the right direction. Let's see... hopefully I'm not going to fall down any holes. Okay. To the other mesa. So, yeah. Run. And there's the portal to the other mesa. And for some reason with shaders, the portal purple thing doesn't show up. So, whatever. But, take a left-hand side. Guardian worm. I always spell guardian wrong. I don't even know if it's right or not. I'm always A and the U. Is it U-A or A-U? I always screw that up. That'll be nice. I'm going to take the shaders off when I come out of here because I haven't shown you this yet. And shaders are in video. I just wanted to show you the nether tunnel and what it looks like with the shaders on. It's kind of creepy and I kind of like it. Good thing the nether's not like that all the time. I was thinking of doing the series on the Renaissance thing that Phaedron made. That would all be done with shaders, and that might be cool, but I already have too much on my plate right now. So, here we are at the Guardian Farm. And as you see, it automatically rains. It's only raining over here because I haven't yet filled in this little spot here. So let me go and turn this thing on and show you how it works real quick. This, I think, is going to be all in the next video this week. As you see, I got hoppers underneath here to detect the things. There's what are those things called? Jeez Louise. Comparator. That goes out this way and it unloads when that thing's full. This is a line of redstone that pushes out a whole bunch of pistons that push out this row of stuff over on top of this redstone, which makes all the carts go. I don't have a sitting room for the best spawning rates for this yet, but for me just being on here, this type of spawning rate is good enough for me. I know I can get more, but I don't think I need it. And there you go. You see all the stuff going out, collecting the goulash, and as they fall, they come back. You can keep an eye on that. It picks everything up. Oh, that just means I'm going to have skeleton horses around here. Just like Exuma, maybe I should bring them down here, but no. The whole top is all filled up other than this one row where the rain is coming down. So I got to put glass across around this whole thing. Then I'm going to fill in the top with water still. Oop, I fell. That's cool. But it's, yeah, so it comes here and it unloads stuff when it's done. And the reason why sometimes these stick here a little bit longer than normal is that I have two lines going past here. So a couple of places takes a little bit longer to unload, but it's really working really well. And you can see all the pistons here pushing all these things out. And so the cool thing about this is that I can come down here. I gotta obviously fix this up. That's what I was talking about. I got everything functional, but I haven't made anything look great. And I come down here, and here's my chest room. Those are the pistons that push out the things. And, you know, we got the stuff filling up. And, you know, I got plenty of stuff for the ages. And I got two lines coming in here, so we got a shit ton of stuff. And so, yeah. I don't have to worry about anything dealing with guardian farms just because of this farm, which took me like 10 minutes to build. It's really nothing. So, but this coming Monday, which would be, today's the 22nd, which is Friday, so the 23rd, Monday the 25th, you will see the video of me completing this. Because the last video was a gold farm. I ran out of gold for these tracks, so I had to make the gold farm, which I'm not going to show you now. And I don't know where the good place to stand, but it seems like the farther back I am, maybe the better. But you've seen, I've seen myself being out here, you know, just out in the middle, and they just fall right on top of me. Here they come. So it's pretty cool, and I got a whole bunch of blocks out here I still have to return to my main area. I'm so happy you don't fall in between piston arms anymore. So I'm gonna turn this off, so this is just done running. And they'll all come back and just stay. And hopefully pick up everything that's on here. And the slimes don't spawn on here anymore because this is glass, and they don't slime. They don't slime on glass. Yeah. So as I get squished by a guardian, I'm gonna say goodbye to you guys. Hope you enjoyed the stream. I'm not sure if anybody even came in because I wasn't able to look at the chat. I'm sorry if you said hi and I was too into this to say hi back to you, but I'll get that fixed in the future. But it's been a productive stream. I got some more stuff to work on my secret project, and that's what I'm going to do next. And have a great day, and I'll see you another day. Oh, let's go kill this Enderman before we go, because we like Enderman. No, Enderman went bye-bye. Okay. Well, have a great day. Yeah. I should just see real quick if there's any skelly horses up here. Let's go check it out. As I say my goodbyes, I continue to go. You mean I could do this for 6-7 hours a day easily. At least 5 days a week. Do I see any horses? No. One thing, if you ever do make these, cover up the streams where the, there's a horse out there. Let's go have some fun. Let's go have some fun. Oh, I don't. I do have Frostwalker. Okay. He will explode into four skellies. When? I don't know. Come on, explode. Bye. Oh, why am I shooting downwards? That's weird. Oh, sorry, horse. I wonder if all these guys come with powered bows. There's one more. Hey. Hey. You don't hurt the horses like that. So, yeah. We got four horses. So how long will these stay here? 15 minutes? Or now that I've activated it, it will be there forever. Maybe there's an island over here that I used to have my base at, and maybe I'll bring them over there someday. I don't know. If they stay there, they stay there. If not, they don't. So let's go crunch. All right. Have a good day. It's Keith. For KMH Corner. Follow me if you like the stream. If you didn't see the stream, understand that I am streaming and look forward to it. If it was any good for you. I gotta bring all this crap back. All this crap back. What do I have out here? Lots of lots. Granites, yeah. Double chest of everything. Okay, goodbye. I'm gonna stop. Bye-bye.